In this video, we're going to finish our excluded values worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section. In order to find an excluded value, we need to set the denominator equal to 0 and then solve for our variable. And that's because we cannot divide a number by 0. Dividing a number by 0 will give us an undefined answer. Therefore, we need to see which numbers we cannot have x be equal to. Therefore, it's an excluded value, because if x is those numbers, or is that value, then it will give us 0 in our denominator, which we cannot have. So setting 15x squared plus 30x equal to 0, I'm going to first start by pulling out an x, but not just an x, I'm going to pull out 15x. Pulling out a 15x from each of those terms, I'll have x plus 2 left within the parentheses, and that's equal to 0. Because 15x times x equals 15x squared, and 15x times 2 equals 30x. So remember that 0 times any quantity is 0. So if 15x equals 0, 0 times x plus 2 equals 0. And if x plus 2 equals 0, then 0 times 15x equals 0. So I'm going to solve for when 15x equals 0 and when x plus 2 equals 0. 15x equals 0. When I divide both sides by 15, I'll get that x equals 0. So one excluded value is that x equals 0. Next, x plus 2 equals 0. I'll subtract 2 from both sides to get that x is equal to a negative 2. So another excluded value is when x equals negative 2. So in number 19, writing our answers in set notation, 0 and negative 2 are our excluded values. And that's because if we plug 0 in for x or negative 2 in for x, we will get 0 in our denominator, and we cannot divide by 0. Therefore, 0 and negative 2 are our excluded values. Let's continue on to number 20. In number 20, again, I'm going to start by simplifying our denominator. I can pull out a 15p from each of the terms. So within my parentheses, I'll now have p plus 3, because 15p times p is 15p squared, and 15p times 3 is 45p. Setting that equal to 0, I'll now solve for when 15p equals 0 and when p plus 3 equals 0. 15p equals 0 when, if I divide both sides by 15, I'll isolate my p to get that p is equal to 0. So one excluded value is that p equals 0. Our next excluded value will be solved when we set p plus 3 equal to 0. I'll subtract 3 from both sides to get p all by itself on the left, and that's equal to negative 3. So our excluded values in number 20 are 0 and negative 3. If p is either of those, then we get 0 in our denominator. And we cannot have 0 in our denominator, therefore 0 and negative 3 are excluded. In number 21, we have r squared minus 8r plus 12 in our denominator. We're in the form of ax squared plus bx plus c, so I'm going to factor, and because my a is 1, I'm going to see what two numbers multiply to give me 12 and add to give me negative 8, so that I can factor this quadratic. So the two numbers that will work are 6 and 2, where both the 6 and 2 are negative. And that's because negative 6 times negative 2 is indeed a positive 12, and negative 6 plus negative 2 is a negative 8. So we'll rewrite our denominator as r minus 6 times r minus 2. And we're going to set that denominator equal to 0 and solve for our excluded values. So when r minus 6 equals 0, that will be an excluded value. And when r minus 2 equals 0, that will be an excluded value, because 0 times any quantity is 0. So setting r minus 6 equal to 0 and solving, we'll add 6 to both sides to get that r equals a positive 6. Now we'll set r minus 2 equal to 0, add 2 to both sides to get that r equals a positive 2. So when r is 2 and when r is positive 6, we will get 0 in our denominator. Therefore, 2 and 6 are our excluded values. Let's continue on to number 22. Note that in number 22, I will be able to pull out an x from each of the terms, and I will also be able to pull out a 2 from each of the terms since those terms are all even. So pulling out a 2x, I'll get x squared minus 10x plus 25 within my parentheses, and I'll set that equal to 0 and then solve for those excluded values. But before I do that, I can factor even further. I need to see what two numbers multiply to give me positive 25 and add to give me negative 10. So the factors of 25 are 5 and 5, where both the 5s are negative. That way, when we add them together, we get negative 10. So I'll have 2x times, now the factored form of that quadratic, x minus 5 times x minus 5. And remember, this is still set to equal 0 because we're solving for those excluded values. Now, x minus 5 and x minus 5 can be simplified. I'll write this as 2x times x minus 5 squared, and that's equal to 0. So what I'm solving for is I'm solving for when 2x equals 0 and when x minus 5 equals 0. Because when any time when those are 0, they'll get multiplied to another quantity, and 0 times any quantity is 0. So when 2x equals 0, I'll divide both sides by 2 to get that x equals 0. So one excluded value is that x equals 0. And then I'll solve for when x minus 5 equals 0. If I add 5 to both sides, I'll get that x is equal to a positive 5. So x equals 5 is my other excluded value. Therefore, I'll have 0 and 5 as my solutions in number 22, because those are our excluded values. Number 23, note that I can pull out a p from each of the terms, and I can also pull out a 3 from each of the terms, because 21 is divisible by 3, 33 is divisible by 3, and 12 is divisible by 3. So pulling out a 3p, inside my parentheses, I'll have 7p squared, because 3p times 7p squared equals 21p, and I'll be adding that to 11p, because 11p times 3p equals 33p squared, and then I'll add that to 4, because 4 times 3p equals 12p. And setting that denominator equal to 0, I can solve for my excluded values. However, I need to factor this further. Because this a is not 1, or not equivalent to 1, I need to see what two numbers multiply to give me a times c, which is 7 times 4, which is 28, and add to give me positive 11. So the factors of 28 that add to give me 11 are 4 and 7. 4 plus 7 equals a positive 11. So now I'm going to rewrite this entire quantity as 3p times 7p squared plus 7p plus 4p, because 7p plus 4p equals 11p, and then plus 4. That's going to be equivalent to 0. Now I can factor by grouping 7p squared and 7p together, and then grouping 4p and 4 together. So I'll have 3p times, pulling out a common term, I'll pull out 7p, so that's 3p times 7p times p plus 1, because 7p times p is 7p squared, and 7p times 1 is 7p. And then I'll add that to, I can pull out a 4 from each of the terms in my next parentheses, in my next grouping. So 4 times p plus 1. And that's because 4 times p is 4p, and 4 times 1 is 4. Now note that I have p plus 1 and p plus 1 within parentheses, so those are the same terms. So now I'll just combine 7p with 4. So I'll have 3p times 7p plus 4 times p plus 1 as my factored form of our denominator. And remember, this is still equal to 0. So notice that this 7p is multiplied to p plus 1, and also 4 is multiplied to p plus 1. However, if you're confused on any of the steps, please refer back to a factoring by grouping worksheet. That's all I'm doing here. I'm just factoring this quadratic by grouping because the a was greater than 1. but the same rules still apply for finding that excluded value. I need to see when 3p equals 0, when 7p plus 4 equals 0, and when p plus 1 equals 0, because anytime those are equal to 0, my denominator will equal 0. So 3p equals 0 when, if I divide both sides by 3, p equals 0. So that's one excluded value. 7p plus 4 equals 0 when, if I subtract 4 from both sides, I'll get that 7p equals negative 4. So then all I do is divide by 7 to get that p equals negative 4 sevenths. So now we have p equal to 0, p equal to negative 4 sevenths, and then lastly, I need to see when p plus 1 equals 0. Subtracting 1 from both sides, I'll get that p is equal to a negative 1. So I have three excluded values for number 23. That's 0, negative 4 sevenths, and negative 1. Those are my excluded values for number 23. And if you want to double check, plug 0 in and solve, and you will indeed get 0 for the denominator. Then plug in negative 4 sevenths, again you'll get 0, and then plug in negative 1 for p, and again you will get 0. And remember, we cannot divide by 0, therefore those are the excluded values. Let's continue on to number 24. Number 24 is a little simpler than number 23 because we're not going to have to factor by grouping. That's because I can pull out a 2 from each of these terms. So pulling out a 2, I'll have x squared plus 3x minus 4. Setting our denominator equal to 0, I'll now solve for those excluded values. However, first I'm going to factor that quadratic, and because my a is equal to 1, I'll be able to see what two numbers multiply to give me negative 4 and add to give me positive 3. So the factors of 4 that will give me a positive 3 are 1 and 4, where that 1 is negative, because negative 1 times 4 is indeed a negative 4, and negative 1 plus 4 is a positive 3. So I'll rewrite my denominator as 2 times x minus 1 times x plus 4. So if x minus 1 equals 0, then 0 times 2 times that other quantity is 0. If x plus 4 equals 0, then 0 times 2 times x minus 1 is 0. Therefore, I'm solving for each of those. When x minus 1 equals 0, I'll add 1 to each side to get that x is equal to a positive 1. And then, when x plus 4 equals 0, I'll subtract 4 from both sides to get that x is equal to a negative 4. So my excluded values in number 24 are 1 and negative 4. When x is equivalent to either of those, our denominator will be 0. Now, number 25, we're going to have to factor by grouping. In this denominator, there is not a common term between all these. However, if I change 49r as opposed to subtracting it, if I change it to adding a positive, I'll group my first two terms together and I'll group my last two terms together. In those first two terms, I'll be able to pull out an r squared. So I'll have r minus 1. Now I also want to get r minus 1 out of 49r plus 49, which is possible if I pull out a negative 49. Pulling out a negative 49, I'll get r minus 1 as well. And that's because negative 49 times negative 1 is a positive 49, and you can see that negative 49 times r is a negative 49r. So I have the same quantity within my parentheses, r minus 1 and r minus 1. And you can see that r squared is multiplied to that, and so is negative 49. Therefore, I'll group r squared with negative 49. So I'll have r squared minus 49, and that will get multiplied to r minus 1. And you can see, indeed, that I'll be taking r squared and multiplying it to the quantity r minus 1, and that negative 49 and multiplying it to the quantity r minus 1. However, this still is not completely factored because I have a quadratic, r squared minus 49. So I need to see what two numbers multiply to give me 49, and that's a negative 49, but add to give me 0. And that's going to be 7 and 7, where one of the 7s is negative. So I'll rewrite r squared minus 49 as r minus 7 times r plus 7, and then that's still multiplied to r minus 1. Negative 7 plus 7 will give me 0, and 0 times r is 0. That's why I have r squared minus 49 written as r minus 7 times r plus 7. So this is the factored form of my denominator. So I'm going to set this equal to 0 and then solve for my excluded values. So when r minus 7 equals 0, that will be an excluded value. When r plus 7 equals 0, that will be an excluded value. And when r minus 1 equals 0. Solving first for r minus 7 equal to 0, I'll add 7 to both sides to get that r is equal to a positive 7. Next, I'll solve for when r plus 7 equals 0. R plus 7 equals 0. Well, when I subtract 7 from both sides, I'll get that r is equal to a negative 7. And then lastly, I'll solve for when r minus 1 equals 0. So all I have to do is add 1 to both sides to get that r is equal to a positive 1. So my excluded values in number 25 are negative 7, 1, and positive 7. That is my solution for my excluded values in number 25. When r is equivalent to any of those, we will have 0 as our value of our denominator. Now, lastly in this video, I'll go over number 26. However, if you haven't done so before this problem, click that like button and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated. Now, looking at 26, right away, I can pull out a 3 and an a from each of these terms, because 3 is divisible by 3, 3 is divisible by 3, and 18 is divisible by 3, as well as a cubed, a squared, and a are all divisible by a. So pulling out a 3a, I'll have a squared minus a minus 6 within my parentheses. And that's because 3a times a squared is 3a cubed, 3a times a is 3a squared, and 3a times 6 is 18a. And each of those is subtracted. However, my denominator is not quite fully factored yet. And that's because I need to see what two numbers multiply to give me negative 6 and add to give me a negative 1. So the factors of 6 that will work are 2 and 3, where that 3 is negative. 2 times negative 3 is negative 6, and 2 plus negative 3 is negative 1. So I'll rewrite my denominator as 3a times the factored form of that quadratic, which will be a plus 2 times a minus 3. Now that my denominator is fully factored, I'll set it equal to 0 and solve for my excluded values. So I'll need to see when 3a equals 0, when a plus 2 equals 0, and when a minus 3 equals 0. 3a equals 0 when, if I divide both sides by 3, I'll isolate my a, and that's a equal to 0. A plus 2 equals 0. If I subtract 2 from both sides, I'll get that a is equal to a negative 2. And lastly, a minus 3 equals 0 when, adding 3 to both sides, a equals a positive 3. Therefore, my excluded values in number 26 are 0, negative 2, and a positive 3. When a is equivalent to any of those values, I will have 0 as my denominator, and you cannot divide a quantity by 0. Therefore, 0, negative 2, and 3 are my last excluded values that I solved for on this worksheet. If you want to leave me a note, feel free to put it in the comments below. And if you haven't done so, like, subscribe, and share.